Yeah, you're right, so tough. Where's the security? Call the security.
No, no. I'm not going to tell people.
He's racist, basically. Just because he saw me an Asian, he told me not to come.
I'm very proud to be a Bay Area kid, born and raised. But one of the things that doesn't make me proud is part of our past. I come from a community that initiated the Chinese Exclusion Act. I remember a guy by the name of Dennis in the time, and he began and ended every speech by saying, whatever else we do, Chinese must go. That yellow fever led to the Chinese Exclusion Act. It's a real black eye in the history of the United States of America, our state, my city. One thing I also want to express is deep, deep recognition of the xenophobia and the racism that is being perpetuated against Asians in our state. We have seen a huge increase in people that are assaulting people on the basis of how they were born, the way they look. And I just want folks to know we are better than that. We are watching that. We're going to begin to enforce that more aggressively. And I just hope people put down their bigotry, their bias, and recognize in a state where 27% of us are foreign-born, a state that, as I said, is truly universal, the most diverse state in the world's most diverse democracy, that in order to meet this moment, we have to recognize our common humanity. And so it's in that spirit I conclude, and I thank all my fellow Californians for recognizing the urgency of tonight's call. And over the course of the next few days, we look forward to working very closely with everybody so everyone understands where we are and where we're going as a state and as a nation. Night, everybody.